Previously on Hell's Kitchen.
She's not gonna get better. She sucks.
Elise took aim at Carrie once again.
Shut up, I'm talking!
I'm tired of hearing you talk!
Whatever. And Krupa had the nerve to say anything.
But then she went after another target, Krupa.
I said her non-bread was a piece of shit.
Keep your fucking opinion to yourself,
no,
though!
No!
In the Creative Chicken Challenge.
It's all down to the last dish.
It's beautiful.
The colors pop.
Elise put her cooking where her mouth is.
Congratulations goes to the red team.
And along with Elizabeth, clinched the victory for the red team.
I won!
Then, during dinner service, in the blue kitchen, Monterey had issues with the fish station.
It fell apart. There's nothing I can do. It fell apart.
And sous chef Scott.
Go it!
It's done then.
Fuck you!
Fuck you too then.
Chino was a mess on the meat.
Come here, you. Look at that. What have you done to this? Now you just fucked him.
Yes, sir.
And in the red kitchen.
I'm walking with scallops!
The chefs were completely out of sync.
Wow.
No, no!
You need to calm down.
Whatever.
You're so fucking disrespectful. I'm here. You're here. Get it straight.
But it was Gina's poor performance on meat.
What is that?
It's raw, chef.
I'd never have guessed.
That brought the red team's kitchen to a complete standstill.
What an embarrassment. Shut it down!
Both teams lost and had to nominate.
Have you come to a decision?
The blue team chose
Chino
and
Monterey.
The red team selected
Carrie
and
Elise.
If you had to drop Elise or Carrie, who would you drop?
Elise.
Time for a difficult decision.
In the end, there was one performance Chef Ramsay couldn't forgive or forget.
Chino, give me your jacket.
And that put an end to Chino's dream of becoming head chef at BLT Steak in New York City. And now, the continuation of Hell's Kitchen.
Now fuck off, all of you.
Holy shit, boys. Oh my God, we have to deal with this bitch again. Elise, she's got problems with everybody. Her attitude is a huge setback for the team.
I just want the drama to stop. I'm fucking embarrassed.
I still love you, babe.
I still love me, too. I learned a valuable lesson tonight. I see the strategy now. Let's cut the strongest one, you know what I mean? It's cool though, I ain't worried about it. Game on. If that's how we're gonna play the game and start trying to cut the competition, we'll let the games begin, cause somebody's going home next week and it ain't gonna be me.
So you're pissed at me?
Oh, I'm not pissed at you. I'm not pissed at all, I'm happy to be here. I just know that I don't have any friends in this house.
It's not about being friends, it's about professionalism.
But I'm a better cook than she is. Why would you want to keep somebody weaker on your team when you're trying to win challenges?
Because your mouth gets us in trouble every service, that's why.
Yes, I have a big mouth. The person I bicker with the most here is Carrie. And if we're both up for elimination, why wouldn't you just want to cut the bickering and keep on winning? Because I'm a fucking winner. And I'll sit here and say that all day, and my modest no, because I know what I've been through, I know where I came from, and I know how I started in this shit. And I'm not gonna stop now. They just woke the sleeping giant. Watch out now. Like I said, I learned a valuable lesson tonight.
What was the lesson?
Bring it on.
Here we go.
As a new day dawns, the chefs are reminded once again that in Hell's Kitchen, the one thing they can expect...
Wow.
What we got going on here?
...is the unexpected.
Oh my God, there's Chef Ramsay with Dr. Jekyll's stuff going on behind him.
We're supposed to go out here?
Come on, let's go.
Wow, it looked like a high school chemistry lab. I have flashbacks of dissecting frogs and worms and stuff.
Right, good morning.
Morning, Chef.
Today I've invited two very special chefs who have an unrivaled reputation for bringing science and food together. They work with NASA to create more exciting food for the astronauts. What? They've even created a delicious frozen pizza that changes flavor to a dessert as you eat it.
Gosh. Wow.
Please welcome Chef Cantu and Chef Roach.
It's Moto.
Good to see you both.
The guys from Moto are amazing. They do the craziest things I've ever seen done in a kitchen.
Ready?
Yes, Chef.
Watch closely.
We're going to make you a dreamsicle sorbet. First thing we're going to do is take this sound generator. We stick it in the orange. Basically, it'll produce a 22,000 kilohertz sound. It takes the cell structure of the orange and turns it into a liquid. We're just going to pour it into this bowl.
That's crazy.
I was astounded. Sound waves, dude? I mean, are you fucking kidding me, man?
Next, a little liquid nitrogen.
The cool thing about using liquid nitrogen is that it freezes so quickly.
It's definitely dangerous. You can freeze and crack your body part off. I really wanted to get my hands on this shit.
Ice cream in 45 seconds.
This was, like, totally awesome. I would have probably done so much better in chemistry class if chemistry class was anything like this.
Delicious. You've seen the cutting edge. But great chefs can do amazing things with very little. And that is what your next challenge is all about. We're going back to basics. Fire and water. You can steam, you can boil, you can poach. All other cooking methods are off limits. Wow.
My mind went blank. I was fixing to get to use this things from the future, you know, but jumped in the time machine and went back 100 years.
Each team will be provided with 6 stunning proteins. Red team, you have 7 members, so you decide which protein you want to make 2 of, and then after you've cooked it, taste and decide which one you're going to present. Got it?
Yes, Chef.
45 minutes to cook, starting from now.
In this challenge, each chef will have 45 minutes to create a unique dish featuring 1 of 6 proteins.
I'm taking the salmon.
I got the lobsters.
I'll take veal.
I'm taking the meat.
I'm doing guinea hen.
We're doubling up prawns. Carrie's doing it and I'm doing it.
Let's set up over here.
Chef Ramsay has designed this unique challenge to test what the chefs can do when limited to cooking with only fire and water.
I have never done this to a filet before.
The team that can steam, boil, and poach its way to the most points wins the challenge.
Oh, I was doing the guinea hen. Hand, Krupa.
I grabbed that shit when there was still 2 on there.
But I called it earlier.
Guys.
Bitch, get off my guinea hen. I chose veal, kind of because it's the only thing that was left. I was very angry about that.
This is fucking bullshit.
Jamie, the only protein we're missing now is veal.
Nobody's doing veal?
I am.
Oh, she's doing
veal. Doing
veal.
Yep. Scared me. I was like, nervous that we're gonna be idiots missing a protein.
While the red team seems to clear up a little confusion over their proteins, in the blue kitchen, one chef...
I'm stumped right now.
...is clearly confused.
I think I should break the prawns down or leave them whole.
I would leave them whole. They would look great.
Yeah.
I feel like my fist is so basic.
We had plenty of time. I don't know how Monterey didn't know what he was doing.
How much time we got?
You gotta ask. It probably ain't that much.
Oh, fuck yeah. He's off the hook.
My sauce is coming out ridiculous, this shit.
I think the judges are gonna love this dish because the veal is gonna be very flavorful. It's gonna be tender.
Oh, 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 Krupa just came a little bit. What?
Eh, that shit tastes good.
15 seconds to go.
Gosh, that time went fast.
Guys, go get them the windows. Gotta move, gotta move.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and serve.
Before judging can begin, the red team must choose which prawn dish will be presented, Carrie's or Elizabeth's.
I'd like Liz's. Look at it. I like her presentation.
Elise, you're saying you like Elizabeth's. You haven't even tasted Carrie's.
Exactly.
I used my eyesight first before tasting. Yes, I did, because Carrie has disappointed us in the past, and I definitely don't want to lose another challenge.
I'm telling you guys, spinach bell pepper with a white beurre blanc sauce. I don't like it.
Whose dish are we dropping?
Carrie's.
Chef.
Why are we dropping Carrie's?
I think Elizabeth's tastes good and looks better.
We're choosing Elizabeth's dish, that's fine.
Even if I were to fight for my dish, they still would have put up Elizabeth's, because I know how my team is. They don't have any faith in me. They don't believe in me.
Here we go. Fire, water, and protein. First, filet mignon. Let's go.
Come on, Jonathan.
First up with their dishes, Jennifer and Jonathan.
Jonathan, please.
Chefs, I basically went back to the basics. Meat, potatoes, and vegetables.
How far did you go back?
Visually, it's a train wreck.
Definitely doesn't look like restaurant caliber visually. but you know, looks can be deceiving.
The beef is cooked wonderfully.
Thank you. They looked like a bit of a train wreck, but it was the best tasting fucking train wreck you'll ever experience, man. Jennifer.
It's a basil ponzu sauce. I never cooked meat in broth before, so.
Yeah, I think you actually nailed the texture.
The fact that you've never boiled beef before.
Never.
And you executed that well, bravo.
Thank you, chef.
Gents?
It's a close one.
I would say by putting forth a little bit more thought in the idea of visually presenting, I'm gonna go with red team.
Red team, congratulations.
Thank you, chef.
Yeah, you nailed
it. Good job, Jennifer.
With the red team leading by one, Monterey and Elizabeth are ready to show what they've done with just fire, water, and prawns.
Ever prawns with eggs benedict?
Prawns, eggs benedict.
Prawns are definitely seasoned, but they're just really overcooked.
Oh God, they're hard. They're solid.
Monterey's dish was a hot mess. He had very overcooked prawns and he did it with eggs benedict. I mean, that's not gonna work.
Today I made for you spaghetti with prawns. I just tossed it in olive oil.
The seasoning needs a lot of work.
I'm disappointed. I expected more. Can I taste yours, please?
Yes, chef.
Yeah. Thank you. Back in line, please.
I think I would have preferred this to that one, actually.
Mm-hmm. You've got a great dish. It gives that vibrance in the mouth.
Thank you, chef. I'm like, hell yeah. Uh-huh. You try it out, girls. Screw them.
Gents, it's too bad they didn't present this one because that one actually tastes better. What a disappointment. No points to either team.
It's all right.
Up next with the salmon dishes, it's Jamie.
Poached salmon with a citrus jasmine rice.
I do think that the salmon is pretty overcooked.
Versus Will.
I cooked the egg over a double boiler like they did back in the olden days.
The textural components and the flavors work really nicely together.
Thank you, chef. You're absolutely right. Congratulations, blue team.
The score is tied at one, and it's time for the guinea hens with Gina.
Lightly poached guinea hen breast with some mushrooms.
I thought the mushrooms with the puree, nice combination.
Thank you.
And Tommy.
We got a poached chicken leg and a breast.
There's just a lot going on here.
Why would you serve the leg and the breast at the same time?
I don't really think when I do things, I just do them.
I think with this, less would have been more.
Gents, red team or blue team?
I'm gonna go with red team.
Red team.
Congratulations, red team. Good job.
Thank you, chefs.
I got the point. I'm like, yes, thank God.
Next up, the Battle of the Lobster.
With the red team up by one, Elise is looking to seal the victory.
Poached in a Vermont sauce.
It is a little rubbery.
Yeah.
While Paul hopes to tie it up.
Citrus poached butter lobster.
Bravo.
Thank you, chef.
Congratulations, blue team. Well done.
Thanks, chef.
Paulie. Woo.
Now, with the score tied at two, it all comes down to the veal dishes. It's Natalie versus Krupa.
I made a veal terrine wrapped in greens.
I don't take it personally, but the terrine kind of comes off as having like that cat food texture.
Meow.
The flavors are lacking seasoning and proper cooking technique.
Not good. Not good at all.
Fuck.
Krupa, let's go.
So everyone knows how much I love my comfort food. So we've got poached veal in like a delicious broth.
Visually, it's pretty bad. I'm just gonna close my eyes and taste it, so. Not surprisingly, it tastes a hell of a lot better than it looks.
I've gotta work on it.
I think it has the flavor reminiscent of like a good beef stew.
Yeah. It actually tastes quite nice. I mean, it's delicious. I have one big issue with that dish. And it's not funny. Especially in front of esteemed judges. That, madam, is not veal. That's filet mignon.
Oh, no.
Carrie, go and get me the veal in there. Quickly, hurry up.
I don't know what possessed me to grab the filet and not the veal. And I know the difference.
Jamie, the only protein we're missing now is veal.
Nobody's doing veal?
I am.
Oh, she's doing veal.
Yep.
Thank you very much.
I just wanted to crawl under a rock. I'm very, very ticked off at myself.
Don't you know the difference between a filet mignon and a freaking side of veal?
I screwed up.
And throughout the whole 45 minutes, no one noticed it wasn't being used. And in front of my guests, how dare you? Red team, blue team, no points, back in line.
It's all good.
I'm so embarrassed.
We have a tie. But, red team, two big mistakes. The screw-up on the veal.
Secondly, the best dish sat on the side. There's no way on earth I can have you winning this challenge. Blue team, congratulations.
Yeah.
Well done. Thank you so much for joining
us.
Look forward to seeing you in Chicago at that amazing restaurant. Take care.
I'm pissed off right now. I didn't win this challenge, but the weakest dish was definitely krupa. It sucks losing a challenge. It sucks being punished.
Okay, as for today's challenge was all about fire and water. Both teams are getting wet. Blue team, your reward, you all are going to one of the finest spas in Beverly Hills. Oh yes. Wow. Relax, chill and sit back.
Sounds great. Man, a spa? Dude, I love fucking massages.
Red team, trust me, you'll definitely be getting wet because you'll be up to your elbows scrubbing the hot tub and cleaning that amazing fountain at the front of Hell's Kitchen's entrance.
Oh, come on.
One more thing. You'll be prepping both kitchens ahead of tonight's service. That's right. We are open for dinner tonight. Got it?
Yes, chef. Way to go, girls. Way to have faith in Carrie. Appreciate it.
This blows.
Blue team, your massage tables await you. Off you go.
Thanks, chef.
Enjoy.
Good job.
Ladies, up to the dorm. James and Andy will call you.
Oh, I feel like shit right now.
We needed this win like we need air. And a spa is probably the best prize we could have gotten, and we lost it.
This is about to be the worst day ever. How do you not know the difference between filet and veal?
It was clearly a veal with the freaking bone and everything on it.
I'm really pissed because it was a tiebreaker, and the reason we lost is because of krupa.
I know.
No, I don't think we're gonna argue about this shit. I'm just gonna be kicking myself for a while for the stupid mistake I made. I'm so pissed off at myself. I am sorry about that.
While the red team licks their wounds, the blue team is off for an afternoon of pampering.
Oh my gosh, this is crazy.
Ooh.
Whoa.
Ryan, how you doing?
Well, hello.
Good afternoon. Welcome to
Thank you.
Prestigious.
Amazing.
Good.
Tommy, you just fit in so well here.
I know.
I know. Oh, I feel right at home. Never been to a spa in my life. I was totally out of my element.
We have a fun day of relaxation and pampering.
What are people gonna put hot stones in my ass cheeks? Like, really weird. Like, just strange all around. I don't care about mineral baths and foot massages and rich people. But you wouldn't have to sell me on the idea of getting used to it.
Oh, man. Oh, that feels good.
Yeah, I definitely needed this.
Boys get their spa, we get our spa.
Yeah. I can't believe we actually have dinner service tonight.
I'm like shocked.
Sucks like doing all this work and losing the challenge and then rolling right into a dinner service.
I didn't hear any splashes, so no one's thrown anyone in the fountain yet.
It smells.
Yeah, this blows.
I don't like this. Today, my pissivity level is extremely high. And I don't have any patience. You're the queens of punishment, man.
I think Elise doesn't realize how bad her attitude is. I mean, she didn't help us win that challenge. So get the fuck over it.
How do you like your scalp massage?
Oh, it's amazing.
This is awesome.
So if anybody would like to get any waxing done today, we do have a waxing station available.
I'll get my face waxed. Who's going with me?
Don't come at me with no wax, you know what I mean? I'm a man, I don't need that shit. I'll use a razor.
Yo, I'll get a brow wax. Oh, I'll man up. Why the hell not? You know what I'm saying? I mean, my wife does it. I mean, how hard can it be?
Man, you son of a fucking bitch.
I'm about to bail. Can I tap out?
One, two, three.
Oh.
Is that bad?
I feel like I got slapped in the face by a large bug.
I think we'll definitely be ready for some dinner service tonight.
While the blue team's day at the spa is winding down, the red team is gearing up for dinner service by prepping both kitchens.
I can't believe we're like going right into dinner service here.
I know, right? I'm kind of freaking out myself.
Oh, boy. Yeah. What a day at the spa.
Tonight going into service, I'm ready to rock. With my eyebrows, I mean, look at them. I mean, they just don't get any better than that.
How's our kitchen look, girls?
I definitely think our morale is down right now, but the red team's got to win tonight. We have to prove that we're meant to be here.
We can do this.
Let's go, guys.
Let's go, Blue.
With Hell's Kitchen just minutes from opening, it appears as though both teams are feeling confident for service.
We got this, ladies.
Okay, James.
Yes, Chef.
Open Hell's Kitchen, please.
For tonight's dinner service, Chef Ramsay has added a tableside special to the menu, halibut sashimi. Jennifer will look after it for the red team.
That's 40.
And it will be Natalie's responsibility for the blue team.
Thank you.
Here we go, sashimi. Wow, straight off the order. 2 covers table 10, 1 sashimi, 1 risotto.
Yes, yes, chef!
On order, 2 covers table 60, 1 sashimi, 1 scallop.
Yes, chef!
Let's go, blue team. Communicate, yes?
Yes, chef.
Don't go too quick on the scallop. We have to put the risotto out first. We'll talk to Natalie to make sure it goes out.
All right.
Natalie, once you slice the first one, give us the 2-minute warning, and then we'll put the scallop. Okay.
3 minutes, so that means you drop in like 30 seconds.
All right.
Who got the halibut sashimi?
I did.
You're in for a treat.
With Paul organizing the blue team, they are off to a good start on appetizers. Meanwhile, in the red kitchen, Krupa is eager to get back in Chef Ramsay's good graces.
Jennifer, can you get that sashimi? I'm about 3 minutes on that risotto.
Already?
It doesn't take that long.
After the disastrous challenge that I screwed up, I'm gonna need a major comeback in order for me to redeem myself in Chef Ramsay's eyes.
Walk in with the risotto.
Because I think he's always gonna view me as the girl who can't tell the difference between filet mignon and veal.
Who made this? Who made that risotto? The risotto's like soup. Krupa, the risotto is like soup. Soup, 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 fucking soup.
Soupy risotto, what the fuck was wrong with me?
Come on, Krupa. I know you don't know the difference between veal and beef, but you must know the difference between soup and risotto.
Yes, chef.
This sucks. I am better than this.
Risotto.
Krupa, cooked perfectly. Okay, let's go. Service.
One fucked up risotto after that, no more.
Krupa seems to be back in the groove on appetizers.
Yeah, perfect. Keep it going.
Meanwhile, in the dining room,
hello.
Jennifer is sweating it out tableside.
This is grapefruit.
Literally.
I was stressed out because I was sweating and I could feel my nerves. Top it off with some fresh orange zest.
God, I'm sweating.
Jennifer, I know it's hot out there.
I know, I'm sweating like crazy.
Yeah, no, but look at me. Napkin and wipe your face.
Okay, sure.
Okay, not in front of the fucking customers.
Ay, ay, ay.
45 minutes into dinner service. The blue team is off to a fast start and have completed their appetizers.
Let's go, guys. One tray, one poached lobster, one lamb, one sea bass.
Yes, chef.
And are relying on Monterey, Tommy, and Jonathan to keep the momentum going on entrees.
What kind of mushrooms for the sea bass?
A little chopped up
mushrooms. Yeah, I got those right here. I had a little problem with the menu, remembering what goes with what. How many of these go with the lamb?
No, those don't go with the lamb.
That's the bass. Lamb, that's the bass, that's right.
Jonathan has a bad memory. You should know the menu by now. This is gonna go into this.
That's the lobster, that's your dish, right?
The lobster, right?
Okay.
Jonathan,
yes, sir.
Where's Paul taking over the garnish?
He's helping me out, chef.
I'm
having a little bit of trouble.
Oh, come on. Paul,
hear
you.
Yes, chef.
Helping me out is a big difference. If I actually taking over, I'm not going to let.
Yes, chef.
Do you understand?
Yes, chef.
Will the garnish be ready, Jonathan?
Yes, chef, it'll be ready.
Because if it's not, you can fuck off.
I'll have it ready, chef.
While Jonathan attempts to hold down the garnish station on his own, back on the red side...
One scallops, one lobster spaghetti.
Yes, chef.
Let's go.
It's up to Krupa and Gina to work together and get out the next table of appetizers.
How long, Gina? Talk to your team.
I'm ready. Can you slow it down? I need about a minute and a half on my pasta.
I'm good to go.
Slow it down a little bit.
Gina seemed to be in a rush to try to get things done, but the pasta wasn't ready, so I kept on pushing it back and pushing it back.
Welcome with the scallops.
Oh, are you? Everybody else ready?
Hold on. Hold 15 seconds.
Welcome with my scallops.
Oh, fuck me.
It's frustrating that she's not listening to me. She was focused on the task that she was doing, but there was no communication.
Let's go, spaghetti.
Lobster spaghetti coming right now, chef.
Yeah, you're not even working as a team yet. Hurry up, Krupa.
Chef, lobster spaghetti.
Undercooked.
Fuck me.
Krupa, taste that. Hurry up. Raw.
I'll give you another one, Chef.
Tina definitely screwed me over, timing-wise. And I had no choice but to take it up like that and then take the blame for it.
Tina, Krupa, all I'm begging for is communication. Get it together. We'll start the table again.
While Gina and Krupa refire their appetizers, the blue team has managed to start sending out entrees.
On order for a poached lobster from Wellington.
Yes, Chef!
And now, all eyes are on Monterey on the meat station.
How long, Monterey?
3 minutes, Chef.
3 minutes.
I was totally comfortable working the meat station because I know it. I had a nice little rhythm with me. Everything was perfect. I felt pretty good.
Oh, fuck me. Monterey!
Yes, Chef.
When the white fat marbling of a Wellington is not even fucking melted, that is raw. Raw. Have you got another one?
I'll fire it again, Chef.
Hurry up!
Monterey put up the food right the first time. I mean, it's like we all know Chef Ramsay's not going to take a rare cut of meat.
I don't understand at this stage in the game.
Yes, Chef.
We'll take that first slice off. And
yes,
if it
chef.
Needs more cooking, don't continue fucking slicing it.
Yes, Chef.
Put it back in. Don't send it to me fucking raw.
Yes, Chef.
While Monterey restarts his Wellington, over in the red kitchen, Krupa is finally ready with her second.
Lobster spaghetti.
Oh, my God. So pissed off. I can't take it anymore. All of you, come here! In my fucking time! What's wrong with that?
It looks like shit.
There's no pasta! It looks like baby food out of a fucking tin. It's disgusting!
All right, Chef.
From a soupy risotto to fucking spaghetti drowned in sauce.
Right now, appetizers is sinking the whole ship.
Hey, you, fuck off upstairs. Get out! I can't bear to look at you anymore. Get out!
I do know I'm better than this. You're the only one who can dig your own grave, and I dug myself pretty deep at this point.
With Krupa banished to the dorm.
All right, I'm going to the window with the scallops.
Caesar here.
Service.
The red team has somehow pulled it together and is now getting appetizers out to their hungry customers.
Excellent.
Meanwhile, in the blue kitchen, Chef Ramsay is looking to Monterey on meat and Tommy on fish to get entrees out of the kitchen.
Two cod, one lobster, one Wellington.
Yes, Chef. 3.5 minutes, yes? On the two cod, the Wellington.
Tommy!
Tommy, how long on the cod? You're driving.
Tommy!
Tommy doesn't talk. He shuts down. He gets real quiet. And then he doesn't talk to Chef, and that's a sign of disrespect to Chef, so Chef gets even madder at him. Tommy, how long?
Tommy, you're keeping us all fucking waiting now.
It's coming, yeah? Chef. It's coming, I promise.
Yeah, but give me a fucking time.
2 minutes, yes?
No, give me 5.
Oh, fucking hell.
You gotta redo that cut. Can't put that out, right?
Fuck, man.
Here, push it back. 5 on that cod, guys. 5 on that 2 cod.
I'm being a leader for myself in Hell's Kitchen right now. I'm making sure things that leave my hands are perfect, and that's how I will be noticed.
Monterey, hey, Bozo, how can you keep on reheating your meats before it's overcooked? I don't know how the fuck you do it.
It won't be, Chef. It won't be.
Monterey and Tommy struggles with their entrees, have left many of the blue diners frustrated.
I've had, what, 3 pieces of that bread? It's just ridiculous.
Meanwhile, the red team have picked up the pace and have moved on to entrees.
2 lobster, 1 Wellington, 1 cod. How long, Gina? Hey, hello. Torty Garnish, you're driving the ticket.
Yes, Chef. Guys, I'm plating my cod.
I need a minute on that cod.
How long, Gina?
Yes, I'm walking.
Chef.
I'm walking with it.
You're
guys,
walking.
I'm walking.
What? You're not walking. Okay, whatever.
Whatever. Oh, my God.
I don't have everything.
You don't have what?
Everything?
When does anyone understand talk?
Gina wasn't communicating with me, and I don't know if she was trying to throw me under the bus, but that really screwed me.
Go on then, Gina. She's reheating vegetables. You're cooking fish to order.
Yes, Chef.
Scream at her.
Yes, Chef.
Talk to each other.
Yes, Chef.
Gina's poor communication once again has stalled the red team. But over in the blue kitchen, Tommy is ready to deliver his refired cod.
Cod, sea bass, Wellington strip. I hope it's working.
He's up with the cod. You plate this?
Wellington.
Oh, fucking God. Will, take a look at this. I don't think it's one pass.
If you don't think that's right, you need to let them know now.
Guys, I don't think it's right. Pull back.
Come on.
Oh, fuck. Fuck off.
Come here, you.
I was me.
I said to you 4 minutes ago, how can you continue cooking a Wellington?
I had 2, Chef. One was over, and I still had one to sell with the other check. Another one was overcooked as well.
So they're both overcooked. You! Come here, you!
Yes, chef.
Last table was the cod, overcooked. Now it's the Wellington. Let me communicate to both of you. Fuck off out of here. Get out of here, both of you. Piss off. Get upstairs and fucking sit and high-five each other. Get out, Tommy!
Everything was ready to go, and Tom kept pushing the time back. It's like I only push it back but so many times. So I was pissed. I had it twice, dude.
Everything clockwork perfect all night.
I had it twice.
I did not deserve to get thrown out the kitchen tonight.
You kept pushing the time back on the Wellingtons.
I did not hand the chef anything that was bad.
You killed me.
I don't know what happened. It's almost like I got pulled into someone else's mistakes. That's not fair at all. There's no way I deserve that one.
It's nearly 2 hours into dinner service, and Chef Ramsay is hoping that Gina and Elise have put their communication problems behind them and are ready to deliver entrees.
Garnish, plenty of fries.
Yes, chef.
Really?
Yes, chef.
I can walk with my entrees now. Are you ready?
I need a minute out when you're walking. You can't just walk up there.
I did call it, Elise.
Well, then make sure I heard you.
It's like two cats fighting.
The communication thing just went out the window, and they're both guilty.
Garnish. Mash, carrots, where's the bass?
Plating now, chef.
Are you sure?
Yeah,
that's cooked.
Here we go.
Hot, chef, very hot.
Oh, stop, fuck off, will you? All of you, come here. Raw bass. Raw fucking bass.
Oh my God, like here it comes.
Anything to say now?
No, chef.
Nothing at all, anything to say? Anybody? Fuck off, both of you. Fuck off upstairs.
I feel like my performance was subpar, but I don't feel that it was bad enough for me to be thrown out the kitchen.
Fuck, man. If my sea bass was okay, I wouldn't have got sent out.
Honestly, nobody was talking to me. And I kept having to ask, what's going, where are you going up with? And you were already walking, and nobody had told me anything. Nobody was telling me nothing.
I know,
so y'all can try to throw me under the bus if you want to. Wasn't nobody telling me shit.
Why are you getting an attitude?
Not you.
I don't know if anybody's gonna throw you under the bus or not. And before that, you're already catching an attitude. That's what I'm saying. Just calm down. You don't know what's gonna happen. Shut your mouths for 10 fucking seconds and listen. There's nothing personal against you. It's just that attitude.
I don't feel that I was the worst.
While the debate continues on the patio, back in the kitchen, the remaining members of both teams hurry to complete dinner service.
Last ticket, ladies. Keep it going.
Ladies, keep it together.
I'm slicing the welly. Walking with my meat.
Okay. Behind chef.
Coming down. Watch your back.
Service, please. Hurry up.
Got a garnish, chef.
Come on, girls. We can finish this.
Let's go. Last table, guys. Hallelujah. Switch off. I've had enough. I am so pissed off because I can't see a leader anywhere. No inspiration, no communication, zero. You're going backwards. Winning team, no such thing. Both the blue team and the red team get upstairs and come up with two individuals from each team that could really make your team stronger by getting the hell out of here. Fuck off.
I think we're both in danger tonight. I mean, red team, blue team, both had piss poor services. He could send two people home, he could send four people home. I don't know.
All right, let's do this. Let's make this short and sweet. Who wants to go first?
I'll have to go with Tomboy Monty, man.
Fucking Monty needs to go, man. Either you can cook or you can't, and he can't. You know, he can't fucking cook, man.
I nominate Monty. The second one, I nominate Tommy. He turned his back to Chef, and Chef was yelling at him. I mean, he wasn't communicating.
Yeah, I know. I didn't do it on purpose. You know what I'm saying? I didn't know.
When you turned your back to him and not say anything, that's literally going like this to him. He just doesn't communicate with the team. You need to be vocal. You need to talk. When you shut down, the kitchen shuts down with you.
We done here, guys? Yeah?
I'm going out swinging.
Elizabeth, pick two. Who'd you pick?
Koopa and Elise.
You.
I really felt like it was a disaster of a service for you.
Was my performance subpar tonight? Yes, but I don't feel that I was the weakest.
Who would you vote for?
I would vote for Koopa and Gina.
I mean, I fucked up this morning really badly, and I fucked up service.
But appetizers did go out.
Harry, who do you say?
I mean, I'm sure you're gonna see me anyway because you would love to see me down there, so.
Will you quit taking it fucking personally?
It is what it is.
Oh my God.
If I had to pick one person, I would say it was Gina. I just didn't hear you. I didn't hear you at all.
You know, we're all guilty of not communicating properly tonight. You know, we weren't communicating.
I was asking, tell me when you're a minute out. Tell me when you're a minute out, and you didn't.
She already said that she didn't communicate.
I know.
She took charge of what she did wrong.
I mean, I know you don't like me, and you would love to see
Elise,
me go up. And I'm not trying to argue with
Elise.
I'm defending myself, and I'm saying what happened on my station. They want to pretend like it's about a team, but it's really not. It's everybody for themselves. Please let me just make it to individuals, because that's where I need to be. That's where I'll shine the most, not trying to worry about these other broads who don't give a damn about me.
I will say this one thing, feels good not to be up there myself.
Paul, first nominee in wine, please.
Honoré, chef. He's had lackluster performances in the last two services.
So your second nominee is?
Tommy. We feel that sometimes when he gets weeded, his lack of communication is detrimental to the rest of the team.
Red team, have you come to a consensus?
Yes, chef.
Yes, chef.
Kerry, who's the red team's first nominee and why, please?
First nominee is Krupa. The challenge with the proteins and also this evening, appetizers, several came back.
Okay. So your second nominee is?
Second nominee is Elise. She failed to communicate and she held up Santres.
Elise, Krupa, Tommy, and Monterey. Step forward, please. Elise, why do you think you should stay in Hell's Kitchen?
I think I should stay in Hell's Kitchen because I have a lot to give. And I know that I'm not the weakest on my team, but I can guarantee you, chef, that if you grant me a second chance, I won't be up here a third time.
So if you're not the weakest, who is?
Gina is the weakest.
Krupa, tell me why you should stay in Hell's Kitchen. Help me.
My last 24 hours have been my lowest.
Are you the weakest chef in the red team?
I would have to say Elise just because of the attitude.
Wasn't looking for the weakest attitude, the weakest cook.
I would have to say Gina as well.
Tommy, you seem to melt down into a little zone.
I could have been more vocal with my team. It was my flaw. But I sure as fuck didn't step down and step back from my station.
You cut me off, and then you cut your team off.
Chef, it doesn't mean I'm giving up. It means I made a mistake.
Monterey, why do you think you should stay in Hell's Kitchen?
I'm definitely not done here. I push for you and I push hard for my team.
Are you the weakest chef in your kitchen, Monterey?
No, I'm not, chef. I think I'm a great cook.
Okay, my decision is... Elise! I agree with you. Gina, take your jacket off. Your time in Hell's Kitchen is done. You are disintegrating. There's no fight back, there's no voice. Please give me a jacket and get out of Hell's Kitchen.
Yes, chef.
Thank you.
Thank you for the opportunity.
Good night.
I do think Chef Ramsay was wrong to let me go.
He should have eliminated Elise. She's a big problem on the red team,
but I absolutely will walk out of here with my head held high. I gave it everything that I had.
Each and every one of you, listen and listen carefully. I have not given up on you. Yes, I'm pissed because I've seen flashes of brilliance. Are you all ready to fight back?
Yes, yes, chef!
Then show me. Good night.
Good night, good night, chef.
I'm feeling like the bullet's coming right at me, and I managed to dodge it. But this is the last time you will not see me up on that chopping block ever again.
Woo, baby! Another one bites the dust.
That's a step closer for me to get to that grand prize. That's BLT and that 250K.
When somebody tries to tear me down, that just gives me the strength to push it to the next level. And I'm putting my game face on, and they better bring it, because I sure will be.
They say good things come in small packages, but unfortunately, in Gina's case, her talent matched her size. Tiny.
Next time on Hell's Kitchen.
We are going to be hosting a high school reunion.
I loved high school.
Carrie and Elise's feud.
Elise, can I please talk for fucking once?
Could get them thrown in detention.
You better get out of my face.
Should have been a model.
But they're not the only ones who are getting in trouble.
Sexy. Why don't you take the yellow thing off?
But at the reunion dinner.
All of you.
Which chefs will flunk cooking 101?
The fish is fucking raw.
And who will start acting like snotty teenagers?
Come on, today.
I'm slicing them.
Dump that pan and start over.
Come on, man.
Not tonight.
Where's your respect?
This is one trip down memory lane.
It's the committee's table.
That no one will want to remember.
I want my five-star meal.
I'm so pissed off.
All next time on a Hell's Kitchen.
Like the Titanic.
It's going down.
Of epic proportions.